And we are back. So now we are going to learn about resolution refutation. So resolution refutation is a technique that we can use in order to prove certain sentences. So whether certain sentences are correct logically or not. So you can prove it by using resolution refutation. So in final examination or final assessment, the resolution refutation question are usually being combined with predicate calculus. The question usually are formed by case study. You will be given a situation or a case study which you have to read it carefully and then convert each of the sentences into predicate calculus. And after that, you are required to perform resolution refutation in order to prove a hypothesis or prove the final sentence, whether the conclusion would be correct or not. So there are several steps in resolution refutation. So first, you will be given a sentence and then you will be have to go through each of these steps. Okay, the first step is to eliminate logical connective. After you have converted all the sentences into predicate calculus, you are required to eliminate logical connective. That is to convert the imply into not A or B, like this. So this is what we call it as inimportant. So inimportant law is important in resolution refutation process. So second step is to reduce negation if applicable, and then you should look into variable name. You should standardize the variable name, or you have to arrange your predicate so that it would be consistent throughout each other. Okay, and then you should eliminate quantifier or column content. So if you have sum, so you remove sum. Okay, here you have sum doc, maybe replace with doc Fido when the name Fido is picked from a domain. And then step 5, you drop all universal quantifier. Okay, and then convert the expression to conjunction or disjunction. Step 8, call separate clause. So every N, you separate it with in their own sentences. So in their own line. Okay, and then you standardize variable again. So if you feel the step by step is a bit verbose, so a lot for you to memorize, then don't worry, I have a shortcut. So this is how resolution refutation would look like. So it look like this. And then you have to cancel it around until you get none. If you get none, until that, the goal will be proven as true. So if this would sound as too complicated, don't worry, I have a shortcut. Just like I told you just now, I have a shortcut. So let's see the most simplest form. So I need to show you this. This is one of the thing that I have to show. Okay. Even if you read it from a textbook, there's no guarantee that you can understand. Most likely you would not understand what you are reading. So here I am. Okay, I'm going to show you how this thing works. Okay, let's say that you have you will be given this question. Okay, like simulate. Let's simulate it just like a test. So kita simulate ni macam test. So let's say test 1. So question number 1. So okay, translate. Okay, translate. Or the sentences into predicate calculus. Okay, so clausal form. Okay, and then perform resolution refutation which prove that Fido will die. So this is an example final examination question where or the test question where you need to convert the sentences into predicate calculus or clausal form. Okay, and then you have to perform resolution refutation which prove that Fido will die. So I'm going to show you how to answer this question. All right. Okay, let's say that all dogs are animal. So all dogs are animal. You have to separate it sentence by sentence. Okay, all dogs are animal. And then Fido is a dog. And all animal will die. And then proof. Okay, Fido will die. So translate this. Okay, translate these sentences. So all dogs are animal. So remember back what you learn. All dogs, say, all dog are animal. So you write it like this, just like the previous segment. Okay, the previous segment where we or subtopic where we have already learned about predicate calculus. Okay, Fido is a dog. So dog here, you write it Fido. All animal will die. So all animal, you write it like this. So every animal will die. Okay, proof Fido will die. So in proof, it will be something different. So you have to write proof. So die Fido, right? Okay, perform resolution refutation which prove Fido will die. Okay, first and foremostly, you have to copy back the clausal form. Okay, first and foremostly, the step one is that you need to eliminate. You have to eliminate the imply. Okay, eliminate the imply symbol. So the imply symbol is also known as logical connective. Okay, the imply symbol or eliminate logical connective. So in order to eliminate logical connective, you put here dot. Okay, dia akan jadi macam ni, not dot or animal. So I like to view it as both elimination, eliminate imply symbol and eliminate quantifier. Okay, for your level you can perform both. So eliminate quantifier. Okay, this is a universal quantifier. You can eliminate this, right? This one, right? And then you can rewrite back dot Fido. And then not animal X or die. And then proof Fido will die. So this one also you write it Fido die. Okay, step two, negate the goal. Okay, negate the goal. So this is the goal. So negate the goal means that you have to put not. Okay, die Fido will become not die. So all in all, you have to rewrite back. Okay, like this. and then you put in not Fido. Okay, you remove proof or the goal, and then you put here not. Okay, step 3, draw resolution refutation graph. Okay, just 3 step. I teach you just 3 the 3 step. So drawing a resolution refutation graph is supposed to be easy and simple. Alright. Okay, you only have to write it here. Oops. Okay, wrong shape. Okay, you only have to put it over here like this. Okay. Dog X. Right, or animal. Okay, you put here like this. So this would be correct. Okay, over here, and then okay, where do I get this line? So I get it from over here. Okay, this one. Okay, I've already crossed it because I write it over here. So let's rewrite another line. So here you have dog Fido. So dog Fido. Okay, you write it here, dog Fido. So Fido here is eliminated. It's not eliminated yet, but you can put over here. So then come to this part where you need to unify. Okay, unify the sentence. So remember back on the previous session where you can you learn how to unify. So this is me unifying the equation. So unify both. Okay, so here you have not dog, here you have dog. Okay, dog Fido. So both of these can be eliminated. So you eliminate this, you cross it, them apart, and then you cross this also apart. Alright, you cross this also apart. Okay, here you cross it also apart. Alright. Okay, so what remain is animal. So you redraw back the shape here. Okay, animal. Okay, X. Okay, what remain is animal. Okay, then what you have here is animal and or die. Okay, or die. So you put here insert. Animal or die. Not animal or die. Sorry, not animal or die. So here you eliminate. Okay, you cross it using your pen or pencil. Okay, it is easier if you can draw it apart, and then you unify them. Okay, just like this. And then here animal, not animal. So okay, you can cross this here, and also cross here. Right? Okay, I forgot something. Because this X and this Fido, you have to perform unification. So when you perform unification, you have to write. Okay, baru dapat full mark. Okay, only then you can get full mark. Fido slash X. Okay, slash X. Okay, you perform replacement over here. Fido slash X. Okay, here this Fido, this X. Okay, this you have to use back what you have learned on the previous session. Okay, what remain here lastly is die. Okay, die. Die X. So die X is written like this one. Die X. Okay, what remain otherwise in your equation? Okay, equation list. So last kali inside your equation list, okay, only not die Fido would remain. Okay, what you have here is put here not die, and then you draw it over here. Okay, not die. Okay, not die Fido. Here and here. Okay, look over here. Oh, wrong direction, but it's okay as long as the meaning has been conveyed. Okay, now. Okay, so remember back X and Fido, you have to perform unification. Okay, just like the previous topic. Okay, Fido slash X. Right here. Only then you can get full mark. Alright, Fido slash X. So, here you go. So, the answer. Right? Okay, the answer for this question. Okay, all dogs are animal. Fido is a dog. All animal will die. Prove that Fido will die. So first, answer this question. Translate the sentences into predicate calculus in clausal form. So then you perform, and then another question is perform resolution refutation, which prove that Fido will die. So step one is to eliminate the implied symbol, which is to eliminate the logical connective and eliminate quantifier. So here are the quantifier. Alright, I'm going to make it much more clearer. Okay. So this is the step. Okay, you have to negate the goal, and then first eliminate imply, eliminate logical connective. So here connective will become not. This is what we call it as inimportant law. So if you've done that, and then you have to negate the goal. So if it's written as proof Fido will die, it will become here die Fido, and then on step number 2 you have to put in not, so not die Fido, and then only then step number 3 is you draw the resolution refutation graph. Okay, you draw the resolution refutation graph. So you draw, and then you eliminate things that are in negation with each other. So this one has not, this one does not have not, and then you negate, and then you produce animal, and then Fido, and then you cross out one by one until you get null. Okay, now finally you will get null at the bottom of this document. So you can see this here, draw the resolution refutation graph until you get null. Then afterwards you write at the bottom, You write at the bottom of your answer. Okay, this one, to secure your full mark, you write here, therefore, it is proven that Fido will die. So, just write it like that. Okay, because you get it now. So, resolution refutation is one of the question where during the final examination or final assessment, you will know that you have performed well. So, if you cannot find the predicate which you can eliminate until you get now, then you will automatically know that you have done something wrong. So, hujung sekali mesti dapat null. Okay, hujung sekali mesti dapat null. So, here you have no outline. And then another one, you have no outline. Okay, format shape. Okay, no line. So, Fido X, Fido X. Okay, you replace it here. So, you write it as, therefore, it is proven that Fido will die. Okay, let's look into another example in your book. Okay, in your exercise book, which I've already given you. So, another example would be... here. Okay, B. Okay, B. All dogs like bones. Dogs eat everything they like. Pasta is a dog. Proof that pasta eat bone. So, how do you go about to do this? So, here are the question. And then, here are how you would approach this question. So, proof. Okay? Okay, let's assume that you've done resolution refutation. So, first, you must rewrite back the sentences into predicate calculus. So, this will become... okay, all dogs like, okay, X, okay, dog, okay, all dog like bones. So, X ni kita replace dengan all dogs, okay, means all dog like bones. You can review back our class, our subtopic on predicate calculus. Okay, before this. So, dog eats everything they like. So, dogs eat everything they like. So, dog eat everything they like. So, X. So, dogs eat everything that they like. So, how to write this? So, all dogs eat everything that they like. So, they must like the things first. Only then they can eat. So, okay, you can write it something like this. Okay, this is the parenthesis. Okay, and then only then they eat. Okay, what represent why? Why means everything that they eat or everything that they like. So you have to put here universal X, universal Y. So all dog like something, then they would eat something. So, pasta is a dog. So, dog, pasta. Okay, okay, sorry, have to write it first. Pasta is a dog. Okay, dog, right here, pasta. Okay, proof. Okay, pasta eat bone. So, eat pasta bone. Okay, remember to follow the format. Okay, eat pasta bone. Okay, x at y. X, y. So, x would be dog. Okay, the dog. Okay, the dog type or dog name. So, x position will be dog. Dog like y. Dog eat y. Y can be bone. Y can be meat. And y can be anything. Okay, then step one is that convert or eliminate connective. Okay, that is the imply symbol. And then remove quantifiers. So what here would become dog. Or like. So they remove you use okay, you use inimportant law, and then you have to put not. Okay, not dog or like bone. Okay, similar to this also. Okay, this one is two step. Not dog, X, or. Okay, or. Okay, this is inside the parenthesis. So, inside the parenthesis also, you have to put in not, like. Okay, X, Y, or it. X, Y. And then you close. And then afterwards, you can remove the parenthesis. It will become like this. Okay. Then pasta is a dog, so this one no changes over here. And finally, proof, eat pasta bone. So, step number 2. Negate the goal. So, you negate the goal or negate the proof. So, we cannot eat pasta bone. Right, you can look here, everything has its pair, except not dog. You have two not dog. So what you're going to do is, you can combine this. Okay, you can combine this dog. Okay, I will show you how to perform resolution refutation. So, step number 3 is to perform resolution refutation. So, we take a page break. Okay, step 3. Resolution refutation. So let's draw the resolution refutation graph. So here you have not dog or like bone. And then, okay, you have to pair it with this one. So don't forget to cross them out once you have already used them. So you draw the shape, right? You draw, okay, identity law. So not dog and not dog, it will become not dog. Okay, this is what we call as identity. So to show you the effect, okay, I'm going to revisit the logic. Okay, logic question. So A or A, dia akan jadi A. So not A or not A, it will become, sorry, wrong symbol, become not A. So not A or A will become null. Okay, it will cross out each other. Okay, here you have not dog and not dog. So what we have here will be the same effect. Okay, we have the same effect. So we have not dog. Okay, cross out both of them. Okay, cross out like this. And then you cross out also like this. Okay, need to make this thing much more thicker. Okay, can have not dog, and then you have like and not like. So this will eliminate each other. So here, okay, you have, okay, and then you put here as not like. Okay, what you have here, not dog, or it XY. Okay, this is the result. Okay, afterward, what else that we have? So dog, pasta, and not eat pasta bone. So here you have not dog and eat. So you choose dog first. Okay, you choose dog first. Let's say that you choose the dog first. Dog pasta. So let's cross this out. And okay, this thing would be connected together. Okay, you unify them. So you cross here, dog. And then you cross here. Okay, dog. Alright. Okay, what remain is just it. Okay, just before I forget, you need to perform unification. So remember back your unification exercise. Okay, you can write it here. Okay, pasta, you replace pasta with X, X or pasta, vice versa. Oops. So what remain is it, x and y. Okay, next you have not eat pasta bone. Okay, not eat pasta bone. So you eliminate this. And then you draw a shape. Oh, ini yang lain. Okay, what we want is this one. So what we have here is eat, not eat pasta bone. So you unify them. Okay, like this. And then you cross here. Okay, like this. Because both are negation. Okay, one of the negation. And then don't forget to perform unification. Okay, replacement. Pasta x, comma, bone, slash y. So the result would be now. The result would be now. And then therefore it is proven that pasta eat bone. So it is proven that pasta, prove that pasta eat bone. So therefore it is proven that pasta eat bone. So you have to write it at the bottom, the note below, to secure your full mark. Okay, therefore it is proven that pasta eat bone. So that is all to know about resolution refutation. So here how to draw it and how to perform resolution refutation. So back then when we look at the exercise, so when you look at the exercise tak berapa jelas. Okay, dia tak tunjuk benda ni di cancel. Okay, cancel. Patutnya benda ni dia ada cancel. In some notes, version of the notes, dia kena tunjuk benda ni di cancel. So sebab tu dia tulis ni exjoin. So bila kamu tengok balik, dia kat sini dia buang happy. Okay, not happy, with happy. And then what remain is just not pass and not or not win. So not pass, not win. And then here, and then it will unify with not lucky and win. So they can cancel win and not win. So C replace with John. So this become not pass and not lucky John. So and then what remain is not lucky or pass. So it, both can be replaceable. A and AB ditukar kat sini, not lucky sebagai A, not pass dia tukar kepada John and history. So because not lucky and lucky dua-dua ni not, dia akan jadi identity. Dia or kan, dia akan jadi not lucky. So dalam case ni dia pilih John. So not lucky John versus lucky John. Okay, it become null. So the goal is proven true. Therefore it is proven that John is happy. Alright, therefore it is proven that John is happy. So nanti kamu tengok balik video ni, rewind. Okay, contoh Fido. Okay, Fido is a dog and pasta eat bone. So when you review back the exercise with the book, with the method that I've shown you, so therefore you will not have any trouble or problem in following or using or answering resolution refutation question. So harap-harap kamu tak ada masalah lah dengan soalan resolution refutation. Okay, therefore pasta eat bone. Macam ni. Right, that's all the time that we have. Sekarang ni pun dah hampir 40 minutes of the running time. Hopefully you can learn more on resolution refutation. So be seeing you afterwards. Kita akan buat sesi latihan dalam resolution refutation. I will show you some of the example from the final examination. But until then, be seeing you again. Right? Be seeing you again. So good luck. Okay, study and then be prepared for your test, and then look also for the final assessment. Review back the final the final past year final examination question, and then ensure that you can answer all the question from the final examination. Okay, see you again.